For everyone planning to drive Highway 36 to work tomorrow, you might have to find another way. The cracked sliding section in Westminster is only getting worse, and it could delay your commute by at least 20 minutes.
Now, the concrete on the eastbound lanes is still collapsing, and now CDOT says that road is so bad, they're asking commuters to avoid the area.
Denver 7's Lance Hernandez is live on Highway 36, and Lance, CDOT plans to shift eastbound traffic into the westbound lanes.
They do. CDOT calls what's happening on that bridge approach a dynamic situation. The earth continuing to move, pavement popping, sending chunks over the side. It was a danger to people working below.
The speed of the separations has actually been increasing.
Over the last 24 hours, that road has moved multiple feet.
CDOT is shifting from a quick temporary fix to focusing on a long-term fix because the earth continues to move under pavement, which is attached to this bridge.
Our bridge demo crews are saw cutting those connections so that the landslide won't damage the bridge.
CDOT says the pavement is dropping because the embankment at the base of this retaining wall is sliding away because of excessive moisture.
We're up here on the road, and you've got a slope like this of grade beneath. What's happening is it's become wet, and it slides back here. It's kind of a radius curve that the whole slope starts to do this. And that's what's happening right now.
Fortunately, the bridge is still in good shape. It has foundations that go down to bedrock. Here's what CDOT plans to do. They're going to turn the westbound lanes into two-way traffic. First, they have to put concrete barriers in place. Until that happens, the eastbound lanes will remain closed.
I've never heard of a road cracking and splitting in half.
Commuters like Emily Edwards will have to find another way to get to Denver.
A lot of inconvenience for a lot of people.
The repair work could cost millions.
Look, I mean, the unfortunate reality of an incident like this is that it will cost money to fix the whole piece, and you know, there are going to be, you know, a number of costs associated with dealing with this whole situation.
Now, commuters are encouraged to use Highway 93 down to 6th Avenue, Highway 7 over to I-25, or Wadsworth down to I-70 to get to Denver. And keep your distractions at a minimum because there will be many people on those roads who don't normally use them. No word on how long this reconstruction is going to take. Lance Hernandez, Denver 7.
That's going to be a mess. Thanks, Lance.